Good morning, everyone, and Happy New Year to you. I'm Marty McNeeley for WGN News. On the Nightbeat, it was New Year's Eve every place other than Chicago. Here in the Windy City, it was not only New Year's Eve, it was also the start of our city's 150th birthday celebration. In observance of that sesquicentennial, Mayor Byrne held fireworks displays at midnight in 18 of the city's parks, with the biggest at Pioneer Court on North Michigan Avenue at the river. Thousands turned out for that display, which literally lit up the skies, despite the fact that the countdown clock couldn't seem to get it together. We'll take a longer look at the fireworks display at the end of Nightbeat. Authorities in New York say three police officers and one civilian were injured in explosions that rocked that city New Year's Eve. An FBI spokesman says one police officer's leg was nearly severed by one of the four blasts. The bombings at four government buildings took place within a 90-minute period. Media organizations have received phone calls from people claiming responsibility for the explosions. One caller saying the Palestine Liberation Organization is responsible. Another saying the blasts were the work of the FALN, the Puerto Rican terrorist group demanding independence for that island. Three people were killed during a New Year's celebration in Trafalgar Square in London. Officials say two women died. More than 118 people were injured when sections of a crowd of 50,000 stampeded after Big Ben struck midnight. More than 30 people were arrested. The last thing the southern states need for the new year is more rain, and they are getting it. Thousands of residents of the lower Mississippi Valley have been driven out of their homes by rising waters that continue to rise. Bill Covington reports.
Governor Dave Cheen got a bird's eye view of the state's hardest hit flood areas Friday. What he saw was rivers and bayous full to the brim, with volunteers stationed along pump lines continuing to sandbag areas not yet flooded. The governor took a land tour following his flight, talking firsthand with some of the victims.
We moved out here, and they said, oh, you won't flood out here.
We moved onto the island and never flooded.
Like my home in Metairie. We're 6 feet above sea level. Now, that sounds low here, but that's high in New Orleans.
We're living it.
The governor is confident federal help will be forthcoming.
We'll ask for it as soon as we comply with the federal regulations, which mean that we have to assess the damage and then have it checked, verified by federal officials, and then it'll go to him. But he knows, because we wired him yesterday, that we would be asking for the declaration.
As the governor got on his departure flight, light rain fell from the sky, increasing the threat of more flooding. In Monroe, Louisiana, Bill Covington for Independent Network News.
Racial tensions have eased in Miami, and officials were able to go ahead with Friday night's Orange Bowl festivities.
The crowds began arriving at dawn. By nightfall, 500,000 holiday spectators lined the curves of Biscayne Boulevard for a view of the beauty queens, marching bands, and procession of colorful floats in the King Orange Jamboree Parade. The two-mile-long parade passed only four blocks from Miami's Overtown ghetto, the site of sporadic racial violence and confrontation since last Tuesday night. Authorities considered canceling this year's parade because of the racial disturbances, but decided to go ahead with the festivities after the trouble subsided yesterday. The clashes between black residents and police were set off Tuesday night by a controversial shooting. Miami police officer Luis Alvarez shot a young black man during an investigation at a pool hall and video arcade. The young man, 21-year-old Neville Johnson Jr., died 24 hours later. Five separate investigations into the incident have begun, one led by the FBI.
Alderman Roman Puchinski says the lifting of martial law in Poland was designed to appease Western banks, and he says the oppression of the Polish people will continue under the new transitional government.
This is no act of benevolence by the junta. They had no other choice because the loans are coming up. They've got to get some extension of credit. As a matter of fact, they passed a budget for 1983 which calls for $3 billion of new loans and refinancing of the old loans. Well, the Western banks have said, we're just not going to talk to you until you get rid of this Hunter.
Paczynski talked Friday afternoon by telephone with Solidarity leader Lech Walesa. He says Walesa thanked Chicagoans for their continued support of the Polish people. Violence flared again in mountains east of Beirut on Friday as top Israeli and Lebanese negotiators prepared for another round of peace talks. The third session is set for Monday in Israel. Neither side is optimistic about an agreement on troop withdrawal since there are wide differences.
At Katz Auto Parts, buy used tires, mufflers, batteries, only $8.88. Carbs, calipers, drums, starters, only $12.99. Used doors, fenders, windshields, radiators, only $39. Automatic transmissions and rear ends, only $69. At Katz, $125 buys an engine. Katz pays top dollar for your car and will tow it away free. Now open 7 days a week. Katz Auto Parts, 4600 West North Avenue and 7370 South Chicago Avenue.